Hey folks, Mike Pizzine here for week 5 of the V8 Supercars Americas. We're at Olton Park this week. Fun track. I always like racing here. It's a small-ish track, and I've always liked small tracks. Lots of elevation, lots of cool corners, bumpy surface. Everything I look for in a Supercars track. So, should be a pretty good result here. In practice, the car was a little loose, and there are one or two turns here where if you're just not paying attention or if you hit them just a little bit wrong, can really cost you. So I think the game for tonight is going to be to play it a little bit on the safe side, just a little bit below what I think I'm probably capable of, just to make sure I don't make any dumb mistakes. We've got 22 cars here tonight, which is pretty cool. I'm sitting 12th in car number 9, and we got a lot of guys around me that are pretty close on pace. So I only got 12th place by, 2/1000ths of a second. The next guy has a 36.4 to my 36.9. The three guys behind me are all at 36.9s in qualifying, so should be a good race. I'm looking forward to it. Like I said, as long as I can keep it out of the wall, I think it'll be good. First turn's a 90 degree left, second turn's a 90, or first turn's a 90 degree right, second turn's a 90 degree left, so I do kind of prefer this side, but it might hurt me in the second corner, but I don't know, we'll see. I don't hate this spot.
Damn it, Ken. dig it, man. You're in top 10. Clear on the right. All right, man, 20 to go. Go get them. north. We have a car stopped on the left. Go right.
The leader is at the start finish line.
The leader is pitting now. Now. Got one on your right. Clear on the right. We have about 5 laps to fuel left. Got one on your left. Clear on the left.
That could have gone better. Awesome right up until the pit stop. Fuck me. I just caught a little bit of the grass. I don't know. I think it's mostly the door, so hopefully the car is fine. We shall see.
That's it. Go.
I still drive straight. We'll be right back.
is hitting now.
Thank you. got you.
On your left. Clear on the left.
Thank you.
Alright man, that car is a lap down. We have about 5 laps left on the field. That's more than enough to finish. 5 laps to go. This time by. Left on fuel.
you.
All right, man. White flag. One more lap to go. One lap of fuel left.
Hold on, buddy. Thanks, Kim. Nick, what happened to you?
I don't need to pack enough fuel on.
We had a bit of a coming together, but I think that was just racing it.
Too many off tracks coming out of turn one.
Oh dear.
Yeah, okay. Did I move on you? I didn't think I moved on you, but we had contact somehow.
Yeah, I think if we get the bike
for us. Yeah, okay. I feel sorry about that, but good race.
Let's put the damn thing in gear.
I'm looking at my belt and I'm thinking, where the hell did you go?
Yeah, I spun the wheels on
us. But at the car.
Gotta avoid a car. Oh!
We'll get him next time.
Okay, see you guys tomorrow night.
Have a good one, bye.
Good battle, Jeremy.
Yeah, it took me too long to figure out how to get around here. Good job.
I'm parking here because I don't have enough fuel to get back to the pits. It was a good race right up until I wrecked it trying to come to the pits. Car was running good. Car was running really good. Yeah, just that the pit stop thing was. Hang on, let me get out of the car. The pit stop thing was totally on me. I know that this place has a tricky pit road entrance, and I did exactly one practice pit stop before tonight, so that was on me. I probably should have done that a couple times. I even thought of it as we were getting ready to start the event. It's like, boy, I should really, you know, I'm comfortable with going around the track. I should really do some practice pit stops. I only did one. So, yeah, just trying to hang off to the right to stay out of the leader's way and caught the grass. And as soon as the car got sideways, I was a passenger. I didn't really have a whole lot of say in what was going on after that. So, and at least the car hit the end of the wall broadside. I think it caught all in the door. So the suspension was fine. The car still drove just fine. It lost a little bit of top end speed, probably from aero damage, but yeah, whatever. Yeah, just a waste of time more than anything else. And then my only other real big mistake was, when I was racing with, Anthony, towards the end there, he used my signature move, which is if you can't get around them, just hang off their bumper and just stress them to death. I know I said before the race, I was going to try and kind of limit myself. But I mean, he pressured me, and he pushed me, and he forced me to make a mistake all on my own. I got nobody to blame for that but myself. I don't know what happened to him, though, because, like, one or two laps after that, he pulled off and went into the pits. So I don't know if he was short on fuel and he needed a spot. He came right back out again. I saw him come back up on the relative. As quick as he came back out, I'm not even sure if he stopped. It was really weird. I wasn't sure what was up with that, but that was good racing with him. From my point of view, I wish it could have kept going like that, and maybe we would have got a good side-by-side battle going, but, you know, the start was chaotic. I was just about to say, he got around me on a mistake that I made, and I can't fault him for that. The start of the race, I really played that card. My God, how many cars in front of me didn't crash? There were guys spinning off the track every which direction. I was just trying to avoid them. And I think by the end of lap one, I was up to like fifth or sixth or something like that. But I knew I had like fast cars behind me. So it's like, well, we'll go back to the original plan and we'll hold these guys off for a while. But if they get a nose in under me, I won't argue it too much. And that's kind of how it played out. Problems aside, I think we definitely had a top 10 car tonight. You can plan and prep and estimate all you want. At some point you still got to drive the thing, and I fell short in the driving duties today a couple times. So I'll take 11th. I started 12th, so I still finished ahead of where I started. But I did definitely show up with a car that should be at least two positions higher than that. So that's what it is. That's how it goes sometimes. I got no complaints. Like I said, it's all on me. So yeah, just have to remember that for next time. Which I'm almost positive I know what track is up next. Let me just make sure. Next week we're going to Chicago. That I'm kind of expecting to be a shit show. I know they changed the track since I did the test drive in the preseason. I don't know. That place, just the idea of having several cars out on that track just freaks me out. So that's going to be a wild card race. If I get a decent finish out of that, I'll be happy with it. I think that race from the start is going to be full damage control. Tonight, moral of the story for tonight was good, ended up decent, could have been better. So thanks so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and see you next week. Have a good one.